Hello, and welcome to Marriage Minutes, a series of short videos discussing the government's plans to redefine marriage. Many people are worried that churches, mosques, temples, and synagogues will be sued if they opt out of performing same-sex weddings. To placate opposition, the government has promised a quadruple lock to protect religious organisations from being forced to conduct gay marriages. There are three things to say about that. First, talk of needing four layers of protection just shows how lethal this legislation must be. Second, the four layers of protection will be quickly stripped away by the European Court of Human Rights, leaving churches and other places of worship dangerously exposed. Third, and perhaps most tellingly of all, it utterly fails to acknowledge the real impact this policy will have on ordinary people. You see, the real threat to civil liberty is the impact on basic freedom of speech. Think about Adrian Smith, the housing manager who was demoted and had his salary cut by 40% just for voicing his support for marriage on his private Facebook page. Or Reverend Brian Ross, the police chaplain, who was booted out of Strathclyde Police Force for backing marriage on his personal blog. Over half of all teachers and 61% of primary school teachers believe disagreeing with same-sex marriage could damage a teacher's career. It's also unnecessary. Equality for same-sex couples already exists through civil partnerships. This radical rewriting of marriage will not add any extra benefits. It will just cause division. It will poison public discourse and drag the nation into a culture war over the meaning of marriage. Freedom of religion for churches is important, but so too is the freedom of ordinary people to speak freely about traditional marriage.